Halo guys, welcome back to MovaSuket with AutoCAD 3D Modeling Practice Exercise number 16. And also don't forget to subscribe our channel here, it will be helpful for us to growing up. In this tutorial, I will create a 3D cup holder. You can see the image here, and you can get this reference image from our site movasuket.com. Okay, we start now. Open your AutoCAD software and first I will change the view into front view. You can click here and change to the front view. I will create line from here to the right here about 72. Okay, and okay again. Zoom and extend, and you can zoom out the object, and we create line from here to the bottom here. Okay, and then I will rotate this line object from this point with a degree about -8, and okay, use a copy command to copy this object to the bottom here about 174, and okay, and enter again to finish. Next, use a trim command to cut this line object. And next, I will select this line and click at this point, move to the right here and press escape button to unselect. We create a circle with a tangent, select this line object and this line object with a radius about 2, and use a trim command to cut this line object, and okay. You can select this line object and delete. We use the offset command with distance about 0.5. Okay, and select the circle, select inside, select this line object, select outside here, and then select this object, click inside here, and okay. Use a line command to connect this to line object. And use trim command, press shift button and select this line object and this line object, and you can trim this line object, and next we trim this circle and this line object, and okay. Use join command to join this all object. Okay, you can select this object and this object already joined. I will use a revolve command to revolve this object from this point to the top here with 360 degree, and okay, can see the result. I will subtract this object with this object, and okay. Next, you can change into the realistic view to view the object. Okay, you can see the result here. You can change the face trees, okay, into 10 point to look more smooth. You can see the result here. Next, I will change into the 2D wireframe and change into the front view. I will create a line from here to the right here about 70, and create a line again from here to the bottom here. Okay, we rotate this line object from this point with -8 degree, and we copy this object to the bottom about 20, and okay, and okay again. Use trim command to cut this line object and this line object. We create line from here to the right here about 5, and go to the bottom in here and select in, click in here, and okay, you can delete this line object and join this four line object, and then you can revolve this object from this point to the top here with 360 degree, and okay, you can see the result. Next, I will change into top view, and then I will create a circle from this point with radius about 75, and okay, Next, I will create a line from this point to the right here about 30. We copy this line object to the top about 10 point and to the bottom about 10 point. And I will create a line from this point to this point. Use a trim command to extend this line object. And you can select this line object, delete, we use a trim command and cut this circle and OK. Use a join command to join this all object and OK. Next, we rotate the drawing by using the orbit command. I will extrude this object to the top here about 20 and OK. We create a rectangle from this point with dimension about 20 and 20. Click here and move this rectangle object from this point to here. We create line again from this point to the bottom here about 80. Okay and okay again. We move this object from this middle point to this point. Next, we change into front view and I will rotate this line object from this point about 5 degrees and okay. Use the orbit command again to rotate this object. Use a extrude command to extrude this rectangle object with a path and select this line object. Next, use the union command to combine this three object and okay. You can select this object and delete. We use a fillet command with a radius about 30. You can select these edges and okay again. We fillet with a radius about 10. You can select this object, enter and enter again. Next, we fillet this edge, and then this two edge and enter. Next, we use the offset edge. You can click here offset edge and select this face. We offset with distance about 3 and 3. Okay, and we offset edge again. Select this face with distance about 3 and 3. And okay. Use the extrude command to extrude this object to this point about 3 and we extrude this object to this direction about 3 and okay. Next, use subtract command to subtract this object with this 2 object and okay. You can change into the realistic view to view the object. Okay, we create the object. And next, I will change into to the wireframe again and move this object from this center point to this center point. And change to the front view. I will move this object to the top here. Okay, and then I will copy this object to this point and move this object to the right here. Change to the top view and we create a plane surface. Click here plane surface from this point to here and then I will move this object to here and we rotate this object from the center point to here. Okay, next, thanks to the front view, I will rotate this object from this point to here and move this object to the top here. Okay, and we move this object to the top here. Change to the top view. and I will rotate this object from this point to here. You can use the orbit command to rotate the object and get the best view. I will change into the realistic view here, and we will apply material into the object. You can tap the mat command to open material browser. I will use metal here and select for aluminium, drag and drop drag into this object. I will use a plastic material here and select to this material. You can drop and drag into this object and then drop and drag into this object. Click this material twice, and then I will use a tin here and change the colors to this colors and okay. I will inactive save illumination and close, and click twice in aluminium drag material. I will change into a chrome and use a tin and change the color here to this colors and okay and close. We close the material browser and I will zoom in the object and use the orbit command to rotate the drawing. Okay, and we active full shadow. I will use high rendering and active environment here. Change the background into solid and change the into white colors. Okay, okay, and close. And you can rotate the drawing to get the best view for rendering. And okay, I think it's enough. And then we try to render. You can click D here, and we waiting for rendering process until finish. It's about 10 level. You also can increase the rendering level into 15 or 20 to make rendering result more smooth. And we finish the rendering process. I think it's enough today for AutoCAD 3D modeling practical exercise number 16. If you have any question, you can comment below this video, and see you next time in AutoCAD 3D modeling practical exercise number 17.